Hello, I am Professor Rios again, and we'll continue with module 4, electrical theory. We'll be doing some problems on the board, and we're going to continue where we left off the last time. The last problem that we that I left you with,
it was this network of resistors, another network to I wanted to show you that this is kind of complex. Okay? But with the knowledge that you have, you can come out on the right hand without knowing it. This is how you work it out. Okay? This is the RC. Okay? RC in this resistance. And there is another RC down here. We name this RC, okay? So if we try to reduce that, we go first like this. This becomes an RT, and this is RT, because this is infinite, okay? This is one ohm, and this is the resultant resistance. So there are two RTs, okay? And that's the way you work it out. At the end of doing the parallel resistance stuff, you have two possible values. -0.7 or -2.7. Okay. A resistor has to be negative. It has to be positive, right? And I'm not going to continue. I'm going to go back to the positive answer. Let's say you're taking a multiple choice. Okay. Answer A, 100 ohm. Is it a possible way that this RT can be 100 ohms? Why? one ohm, right? Even if we didn't have this, it would be 3 ohms. So it cannot be 100 ohms, right? Could that actually be 75 ohms?
No,
because of the same reason. Could that resistance be 1.5 ohms?
No, it's big.
Oh, yeah.
No, we know that. Because it's here. Right. Is it possible to be 1.5 ohms?
Could be. We don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
But remember, this is infinite. Mm-hmm. Okay? At the end, and we have another, this is maybe, okay? And then maybe. How do we decide between this two? No, if you work it out, you have to do this. Remember, you're sitting in the set of projections, you have a number of choices. You do it by elimination. This can be. If you try to work state plan that you don't have. Okay? But I'm teaching you now, it's a rule, it's a resistor, and multiplication is every addition. Two resistors are the same, half of the value. That's what I'm trying to get at.
When it comes to this multiple choice.
Can you show me how this class is, where I find the answer?
This is beyond the scope of the class. Okay, this has to do with complex numbers, that it can be two plus minus square root of 12. Every set, what am I gonna do? So, what this is trying to tell you is that it's complex. It's not a simple thing, okay? No, by adding from that, no, that's the reason we're doing. Because we say RT, okay, this RT becomes the resultant resistance of the rest. Remember, it's infinite.
Yeah.
Okay? I was trying to calculate it before that RT, and those RT are actually the same. Okay? Have you ever heard of a coaxial cable of 75 ohms? A coaxial cable of TV?
Yeah.
Coaxial cable?
No.
Coaxial cable for TV is 75 ohms. The cable is in this. The center conductor. And it has a mesh, a gas pipe. Okay? For the thing is, then it's for TV, it's 75 ohms.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, this termination, if you don't want, they would use for us.
They're all switching on the power.
Yeah.
As it goes on the.
We still.
Yes, sir.
Okay? There are places where the fiber optic doesn't reach.
Yeah, because you don't.
What I'm gonna tell you, this is 75 ohms, no matter how long it is wired.
Are you talking about the.
This is the representation of that. Anytime you cut it, if you look into that, come on. Okay, that's what I'm specifically giving you, what time you get this? And we get into a very complex stuff, okay, with frequency stuff. Bottom line, you have two RTs, okay? And then you have two resistors in series with this. We should do this in parallel with the addition of one plus one plus RT. One plus RT is what this is here. Okay? So, then you solve it, and you get to this equation, RT squared is equal to RT, you know, and then when you solve it squared, you can have two plus one plus minus, right? Is that a little better idea? I think that's pretty possible. You have to be this. But I'm gonna tell you, you don't have to go through this. Your goal is to do good in the test, right? Based on the information that you have, it is way beyond what you need for that. And this is a problem, okay? You only use the point that is gonna break you, or you're saying things like, is that, is it? All right? That's my goal. When you see this, it's impossible for the, value, it's impossible to value. If you put it right, it has to be positive or less than 1 ohm. You know, that's the problem, you never find something like that. That close, they're not gonna be that big. But if you wrap it something like that, which is unlikely, okay? Mostly, it's gonna be like this.
Okay.
Yo lo resolví, profesor.
Muchas gracias.
Yo lo resolví en la. Yo lo resolví eso, pero no lo puse en infinito como usted, a mí me salió 0.78.
¿0.73? 2.
O sea,
¿sí?
A mí me salió 0.7318.
¿Sí? ¿Y ahí como no lo serviste? Sí, hace
todo. Oh, con la misma fórmula que la transparencia. La misma fórmula como resolvíamos todos los problemas.
A ver. A ver qué se dice.
Lo mismo voy a ir. Sin eso,
a ver,
¿cómo se? muy reducido. Puede tener una simple traducción. Pero es que este es aquí, vamos a registrar. Puede ser que tenga que ver como que. A ver, vamos a decir. Este, ¿cuál es el límite de la traducción? Este. Bueno, bueno. ¿Sigue? No, no.
Keep on it. Take the information that you have. You have a 99% chance of getting it right.
Okay? Profesor, antes de ese hubo otro problema que hizo.
If you keep on doing that, it is lower and lower and lower.
Okay?
It's all the last problem.
The other problem was this one here, right? Well,
this one like this, and resistor here, and then one like this, one like this. Something like that?
Yeah, something like that.
So in the lower part was 10,
2.2. 10, 2.2K.
Yes.
10 and 2, no.
2.2, 2.2, yes, that's right.
10 and 2.2.
Okay.
So we need to calculate that. So how do we do this?
Right away.
Professor,
2.2
and
10.
2.2 and 10?
Yeah. 2.2. If I change the order of this resistor, will it be the same? If I change the order of the resistor, will the value be the same? Should be the same, right? Same as here. So how do we do this? You want to do it?
I need to be able to do this, okay? How do you do that? What is the first step to do this? Parallel resistance. This is something that you guys can do. The other one, no, but this one, yes. No. I want to know your thinking process to do it so I can help you. If I don't see how you attempt to do it, there is no way I can know. Okay. Está conectado ahí.
Es lo mismo, eléctricamente es lo mismo.
Listen.
Listen, I need you to come here, okay? And then tell me how you intend to do it so I can help you. But you're going to be less than happy. You're going to see the problem like this and you want to do it. Okay? This is a learning problem. But you have to be your friend. What is that 1.1? Simplify. Okay.
Before you start doing anything, I want you to tell me which resistors are in series and which resistors are in parallel. That's key number one. They're all parallel. Why all of them are in parallel?
Witness
Okay.
These two are in parallel.
These two are in parallel.
Okay, with this. This end of this.
Very well.
Yes. And
very well. Exactly.
And then the rule of resistance is half.
Exactly.
Right? So it's not.
So you're saying that that 10 and that 10 are in parallel. You just told me that the two top resistors are in parallel and the two lower resistors are in parallel.
Yeah.
That doesn't make the top resistor in parallel with the bottom resistor. This is the skill number one. We need to find out what is in series and what is in parallel. Okay? Once we find out what is in series and what is parallel, we apply the rule for parallel resistors and we apply the rule for series resistors. Okay? Is it clear? Okay. Ruben, you know how to do this, right? Okay, so I want you to try. Eric? You got it. Sir? Tell me which resistors are in parallel. No, mark it with this. I mean, this is a learning process. Come on. Even if you want to stage in front of 1,000 people, you are learning, okay? Don't worry about it. Tell me which resistors are in parallel and which resistors are and why. The important thing is why, okay? It's funny, unless we do this 100 times, it seems that someone got it. But when you give a different problem, you realize that they didn't get it yet. So we have to work on it. Okay. That one is parallel with
perfect.
Okay. What else? Okay. So how do you solve resistors in parallel? Exactly. Very well. Yes, that's correct. That is correct. Yes. Listen. It is the following, okay? If someone tells you that is wrong, you have to understand that is wrong, okay? When you are working as an electrician,
an inspector comes. Now with this,
okay? And they write you up. And they look, this is wrong. You have to know why it's wrong. It's not because the inspector feels like it. Okay? So you have to tell him, why is this wrong? Most of the time, I'm going to tell you, get a licensed electrician to check this. Because the licensed electrician, whenever they're going to do something, they go back to the National Electrical Code, to the chapter that, for example, for the outlet, and this will tell them the actual code. This is for 2017, the last one. This changes every 3 years. What is the height to the floor? How far it has to be from each other? So if you are compliant with that, for that environment, you have commercial, you have industrial, and you have a special environment. And a special environment is a hospital, a hangar where they repair planes, a gas station, okay? Each of them have the rules, everything is here. So if you follow those rules and expect to tell you something is wrong, you can tell them, that's right, sir. What I did is here, look, this is the code. Then tell me what's wrong. then you're talking with knowledge. But it's not like, that's wrong. And you go, okay, I'll fix it. You don't know what to fix. I want you to know what it is. So if he told you that this is wrong, then why is this wrong? Why this is wrong? You see what I'm getting at? So those two are in parallel, okay? Those two are in parallel. The burn resistance are in parallel. When you get the value of those four, but you see, the point here is that to clarify these things, you have to do circuit reduction, not only the calculation.
Okay. This one you need to do. Look, before doing any of this, this is what you need to do.
No, what's right? The first thing that you need to do, circuit reduction. Exactly. Pay attention to this for a second. When everything was right, okay, and you need to redraw the sequence so everything is clear. If there is one step, you figure out. But if you have five different steps, at the end you get lost in the maze of numbers. Okay? So you need to do sequence. If I'm going to combine this two and this two, I need to draw the equivalent resistance. So I'm going to have a wire here, an equivalent resistance, an equivalent resistance. This is R total, right? This is going to be R, then in parallel with 2 with 2. And this is R. Then in parallel with 2.2. Okay? When you put two lines like this, means that this resistor is in parallel with this one. Now you can do the multiplication by the division. What was the value of this? 1.8? So the value of the multiplication by the division is 1.8. And it's equal to 1.8. Okay? Now you do the reduction. This is an object reduction. This is a line, a resistor. So when you add these two, you get this one. It's 1.8 plus 1.8. But if you do this, if you don't do that reduction, you get lost in the maze of numbers. Circuit reduction. Circuit simplification. No, you see those two there becomes one because you combine the parallel. You ask what is circuit reduction? Circuit reduction is simplification. What is simplification? Combining the resistors according to the series and parallel. The top resistors, the first two resistors are in parallel. So you combine them, you draw an equivalent resistance. The two bottom resistors are in parallel. You draw an equivalent resistance and you write where that came from. So you write R10, two lines, that means in parallel with R2. We know that you do the multiplication by the division. It's 1.8. Then with this one, I need to further reduce this. I just add them. So I combine those two and becomes this one. It's equal to 1.8 plus 1.8. What is it? 3.6. Okay. Do you see that if you do this in order, there is no way you can make a mistake? But if you start doing simplification, the multiplication, because I combine these two, and then you got to, wait a minute, which one is the one that I combine? You lose track. Like, you do the secret simplification, and by the way, once you do a simplification, what based on which you forget about this? Welcome back after the break. Thank you. Let me say, stop recording. Go ahead. That one? No, that's okay.
So now,
okay. Maybe you were thinking right.
I was thinking, when I have the conversion for this, and then I found 1.6, 1.6, okay, 1.8.
Why you cannot add that?
Because
that resistor is not in series with this one. And why is not in series? Because you have another path of current. Okay. That's why I need. Pero hay que entender que todo eso es un punto. No importa. Eso es lo mismo que si yo pongo todo eso en un punto. ¿Ok?
Eso es lo mismo que si yo hago esto. Eso es lo mismo que si yo hago esto.
Mira.
Uno este punto con este. ¿Ok? Un punto común. Y es lo mismo. Es la parte de arriba está conectada con la parte de abajo está conectada con la parte de arriba y ya se ve que está en paralelo.
Ahora ya lo tenemos claro.
Esta conexión puede ir a donde sea y volver aquí. Esta conexión puede ir a donde sea, dar 30 vueltas y volver aquí. Esta conexión puede ir a donde sea, dar 500 vueltas y volver aquí. Así es difícil, pero si seguimos el camino, ¿ok? Decimos, esta está conectada, la parte de abajo está conectada con la parte de abajo. ¿Está la parte de arriba conectada con la parte de arriba? Pues lo sigo. Esta viene por aquí, viene por aquí. Viene por aquí, hasta aquí. Esta viene por aquí, hasta aquí. ¿Ok? Pero también viene por aquí, y llega hasta aquí. Están conectadas las dos. La verdad es confuso, ¿sí? Lo que hay que determinar es que sigue, o con la vista, o con los dedos, si se encuentra en la línea. Esto es un extremo. María estaba poniendo un circuito. Sí. ¿Ok? Hay que seguirlo. O con la vista o con los dedos. Si tú sigues el circuito, la parte de abajo de la resistencia, ¿ok? Y se unen. Y la parte superior de la resistencia y se unen, eso está en paralelo. Aunque este dedo recorra 10 millas, y este recorre 10 millas. Si vuelve a un punto y se conecta, esos dos están en paralelo. ¿Ok? Eso es lo importante. Que si la línea está conectada más arriba, que si está más abajo, eso es irrelevante. ¿Vale?
Fíjate, esto lo hemos hecho, pero todavía hay gente que tiene dudas. Por eso hay que seguir haciendo esto. Porque no,
sí, a mí también me presenta un problema así un examen de eso y dice, niño, esto yo no sé hacer y ya.
Me fastidió. A mí también me pareció, me cambió todo de la conexión por debajo de la mano, pero después.
We're going to break. We'll be back in a minute. Hello, this is Professor Rios. We're back from the break, and we're trying to solve this problem here. We have a resultant resistance of RT, which is 7.2 k-ohms, okay? And this is the resistor network all of them should have the same value. Let's find out what they are. This is one of our students.
Given the value that all of them are
1.8.
All four values are
1.8. So what value do you get?
Huh?
What is the resultant resistance?
The total resort resistance is 7.2 if you give each resistance.
No, but if you solve that problem, if you solve it, if you give those values to the resistor, what is the resultant resistance?
The total resistance.
Exactly. They work?
Yeah.
Do the, I don't see the reduction. 1.8. In parallel with 1.8, what is half of that?
Half
of 1.8. To draw the circle, we have the value. 49. You know what I mean?
49. No, wait.
Let me show you something here.
It's very easy to do. Okay. Circle reduction. Okay. I'm going to combine these two. I'm going to have a resistor here, a resistor here, and this one is R1 in parallel with R1. Okay. This is R1, this is R1, and this is 7.2K. So since you gave to this 1.8, right?
Mm-hmm.
All of them is 1.8 times 1.8 divided by 1.8 plus 1.8. That is what?
That gives you...
Do it with the...
Right, exactly.
No, but how do you
Mr. Martin, Professor,
So,
3.24 ohms?
Yeah, yeah.
3.24 divided by,
yeah, 3.6.
3.6?
3.24.
3.6.
No, 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 I'm concerned about the R1 and R1 in parallel.
So you tell me.
That's a separate reduction. You put R1, the ones that are on the right, in parallel. He says that is 1.8, so we're doing multiplication divided by addition. And we start to calculate what is the value of those two in parallel.
Thank you. What's
happening? Do you remember what rule? Do you remember what rule do you use when two resistors in parallel are the same?
Two.
You don't have to do that. But do it. You're gonna give you the same value. I don't know. Two resistors in parallel that are exactly the same. He has the value of one of them. He's doing the calculation. But we're going to prove that what he did belongs to is exactly half of 1.8. So, No. All we're doing right now is combining R1 and R1, the one that are on the right. That's it. We're taking one step at a time. He did some new theorem that he invented, and we're trying to prove it if he's right or wrong. Basically, it. Okay? So that's 0.9, right? So write that value over there, 0.9. Right here, this is 0.9 ohms. Okay. So, how do you further reduce this? This plus this. So, do a circuit, a resistor, in parallel with another resistor that will have 1.9 plus 0.9 here. No. Draw the circuit. Huh? No, listen, if you don't draw a circuit, you'll never be able to do what is right. You can resist, put a resistor here, put another resistor here. This resistor is minus 2. So you got those two, it's 1.8. So connect those together over there. No, wait a minute, yeah. Connect these two. Put the line like that. Okay, this is 1.8. So 1.8 in parallel is what?
0.9.
So according to your theorem, it's 0.9 ohms. And the resultant resistance is 7,200 ohms. It's way, way out of.
So how do we solve
it? But that's the tip, because none of them have a value, so how are you going to solve it?
I didn't say that was right. I was just trying to know where it is.
Okay.
And I came out.
Based on these numbers? Based on what?
So what do you think the 3.515 on that?
No, but what is this? 3.15.
What I did was
But those are thousand of homes. That is 7,000. That's in cake. And those are cake.
Well, you said R1 is everything.
It's the same.
It's the same.
Exactly. It's our reduction.
Okay, you have one apple plus one and a half apple. How many apples do you have? One apple plus half of an apple.
7.2.
No, it's 7.2. Okay? You see? One apple plus half an apple is 1.5 apples. Okay. We're going to break, and we'll be back soon with this exciting problem where my students are reinventing the rules. Fantastic. Hi, I am Professor Rios.
We're back from the break, and we're going to start.
Okay. This is the total resistance, okay, and equal to what? This resistance divided with the rest. So R1 in parallel with the rest. That rest is these two. This in series is two in parallel. R1. No. R1 is in parallel with these two. No, R1 is in series with these two in parallel. Look at this. R1. Is in series with to add them with these two in parallel, which we know is R1 divided by 2 because they are exactly the same thing. R1, and R1.
Okay. Yeah, I get that. So
it's half of R1.
Yeah. So basically, this number right here would be here, 7.2, right? Because you said anything in parallel are the same value, correct?
Anything in parallel. No, what we're stating okay. here is that each of our resistors have the same value.
Okay.
The original resistor. Now, when you combine them, we see that here is going to be half of the value. If you combine these two, because they're the same.
Okay. So you're telling me that 7.2, half is 7.2. You're taking half of that.
No. 7.2 is the resultant resistance of that.
That's the end result of everything.
Exactly.
Okay.
If you get the multimeter and you measure at that point, you get 7.2 K.
Are you trying to figure out how we got this?
We're trying to figure out the value of each resistor.
Okay, so get add to 7.2.
Exactly.
So we know right now, you still have
no. This is in series with this level is in parallel.
So
and at the same time, this is in parallel with this. The whole thing is in parallel with this. No, all these are, well, this is not in parallel with this. This is not in parallel, but in series with this. So,
when you combine this with that and that becomes parallel,
you combine this two and add in parallel. The resultant resistor is in series with this one. So, you add this.
So, when
this is what this graph is.
Once you add that with that, would that find the result parallel
with that? Exactly. It is parallel. Because the beginning of that resultant resistance is connected to the beginning of R1. If the end of that resultant resistance is connected to R1. Exactly. That's what we're doing. Where do we get the 1.5? R1 plus R1 divided by 2 is half. If you have one apple plus half of an apple, you have one apple and a half.
Because this would be 1 and 1, but because of the same,
it becomes R. So this is R plus R over 2 is 1.5 R1. Let's call R1 apples. And you have one apple plus half an apple. You have one apple and a half. You're looking at it, right? You visualize it. So that's
That's how you get this 1.5. No, it's not a formula. We're just solving the problem. It's a result of solving it. It's not a formula you have to learn that you write it down because it is a different system. It doesn't hold.
R1 is in parallel with this
result of the system. So that's what it means. R1 in parallel with 1.5 R1.
So now it's 1 times 1.5.
Now, how do you do parallel? Multiplication by divided by addition. You multiply R1 times this divided by R1 plus 1.5 R1.
So
1.5 R1 is 7 times 7 is the same as 7 to the second value squared. Okay. R1.
That's this part right here, right?
Yes. This is that. We're doing the multiplication divided by addition of the resultant resistance between this point and this point and this one.
Yeah.
Okay? So R1, which is this one, multiplied by this total resistance, 1.5 R1, which is right here. We're reducing it. R1 times 1.5. R1 is what? 1.5 times R1 squared. Let's do it with numbers. If R1 was 5, for example, times 1.5 times 5 is equal to 1.5 times 5 squared. 5 squared is 25. 5 times 5 is 25. Okay? I don't get the part why you square. Okay. It comes out to 5 times 5 is what?
25. 5 to the second value is equal to what? 25. When you multiply
number by
itself,
you get the square
value. That's not mean by itself. That's 1.5 and 1.
We're multiplying the R1 and the R1.
So we don't really know the value of R1 yet?
Not yet.
Okay, so
we're going 1.5
okay.
times R1 times R1 R1 squared. So 1 times 5, R1 squared, no, divided by 2.5 R1, one cancel out with this one, and you're left in the denominator with 1 R1. Divided by 2.5.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
So now
you solve for if all this is equal to 7.5, 7.2, you can solve for R1.
Oh,
yeah. Right?
Yeah. Wait, so I'm saying how you
okay.
Divide it, right?
Because yeah. Now we have 7.5, 7.2. Equal to 1.5 R1 divided by 2.5. What are we looking for? This. How do I
show
for R1? Divide. You can divide this into this and divide this.
Are you cross?
You cannot do that. You can do 7.2 times 2.5 divided by 1.5 times R1. And all this is equal to 7.2. This times this is equal to this times this. Like that. And this times this.
than this.
Yeah.
Right? Now, R1 is equal to what? The one to use it for itself?
One
point. I go to the other side, what?
Divide.
7.2. 2.5 divided by 1. Is equal to 1.25. No, no, whatever word you wrote, you get lost.
So this square is right here because
what is?
So we still don't know the value of R1, right? We still don't know the full value of R1.
Because we're calculating.
But we know that 1.5
is 1.5
combination. So you 1.5 R squared because these two become squared.
R times R is R squared.
R squared. And then
this is the multiplication divided by addition.
So how do you gain the value of 1 on this?
No, no, this is not 1. It's R1. It's the name of the resistor. R1.
2.5 there.
No, because what I'm doing is 1.5 R1 plus 1 plus R1 is how many R1s?
We don't know.
If you have one apple, okay, plus one apple and a half, how many apples do you have?
R1. But we squared it here, so why are we not squaring it here also?
Because we're doing the multiplication divided by addition. Okay. What I want to do is the circle reduction.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
yeah, but 1 times 1.5, that would be 1.5.
Exactly.
Why he squared it?
Okay. So we got R1, right? So this right here, green means we got to multiply. So this 1.5 with R1. Okay. So this goes into this. You get this is one. Okay. This is all. This is just one. This by itself is considered just one. Okay. Even though it's not there. So one gets you 1.5 R2, okay? It's because you're multiplying here. So 1 times 1.5 equals 1.5, but since this is a R, you combine these and you get 2, so it's 2 squared, okay? Now, since you're adding it right here, so this is really 1, and then you're adding that, and you get
1.5 R1 is how many R1 is. Are you like giving the value?
No, I'm not giving any value.
We don't know.
We don't know.
This right here, you're all figuring it out.
But you get what I'm saying? This by itself is considered one. Since you're multiplying, it's 1.5.
Yeah.
So you combine that, and it's just one. This is one.
Now when we get to this point now, so it's 1.5 R squared divided by 2.5, but because you said
two,
it cancels, so now it becomes
1.5.
Exactly.
One of the cancels.
Exactly.
This is the same as this. 1.5 R1 times R1 divided by 2.5 R1. One of these candles is 1.5 R1 divided by 2.5.
Now when we get here now, we divide 2.5 by 1.5.
We can do that. You can divide this over this times R1 is equal to 7.2. You can do that. 7.2 is equal to R1 times. You divide that. Give it a
value.
This is my phone. So we don't remember the
anymore. 2.5 divided by 1.5.
No, 1.5 divided by 2.5.
Exactly.
Hi.
Good morning.
Okay. That's all for the class.
Oh, you're here. Okay. My name is Stephanie Rodriguez.
Yeah,
please. I just want to let you know that on Saturday we have a meeting
Thank you. Our professor invited.
I'm asking.
Thank you.
Is it clear?
You have it clear, right?
Yeah, or not?
Not quite. Yeah. ¿Usted puede hacer eso si borro la respuesta? No, pero lo puede hacer si borro la respuesta. ¿Por qué no? Si lo entiendes, entonces no lo entiendes. Crystal, can you do this if I raise the answer? If I raise the answer, can you do it?
R1 divided by 2.5, okay?
So if we want to solve for R1, this one goes to the side multiplying, and this one goes to the bottom dividing. So it's 2.5 divided by 1.5, and multiply times 7.2. You see, this one that is in the bottom
goes to the top,
and this one is in the top, it goes to the bottom. Because you're going to get two this against this.
Okay. 7.5, 7.2k is equal to 1.5 R1 divided by 2.5, right?
I'm sorry for R1.
We don't divide this.
No, you can do it.
Divide
at that 0.6.
Oh, you can do it. Okay, if you want to divide it, you do it like that.
You can do 7.2k is equal to 0.6 times R1. So R1 is equal to 7.2 divided by 0.6. Let me give you 1.2.
Then you
got to
move the decimal.
No, 7.2.
7.2 will be more.
Okay.
En español. En español. Who? Can you pray to him, please? Can you play that?
Este en paralelo con esta resultante, que es R1, es esta,
es paralelo por la resultante entre este punto y este punto. Bien, esta serie cuando no es paralelo. Es esta que se añade, porque está en serie, con estas dos en paralelo. Eso es. Y esto es igual a este punto. Entonces ahora es como si tú lo estamos haciendo. Y yo digo que 7.2 clases. ¿Ok? ¿Qué es esto que está aquí? La entrada. Es igual a qué. A esta resistencia en paralelo con esta red que está aquí. Esto está en paralelo con esta red. Desde este punto a este punto. ¿Vale? Y esta red que es esta en serie con esta red en paralelo. Este R1 más, porque está en serie, esta es en paralelo, que es R1 dividido por 2. Si es un valor, se divide por la mitad. ¿Ok?
Y eso da un resultado, ¿eh?
Entonces, esto, si yo hago la suma de esto, una manzana más media manzana, que es manzana y media, ¿no? Por eso es 1.5 R2, R1. ¿Ok? Porque esto es lo mismo que esto. ¿Estamos de acuerdo? Entonces, si esto está en paralelo con esto, ¿cómo se hace? La multiplicación dividido por la suma. Tenemos R1 por 1.5R dividido por R1 más 1.5R. Es la otra vez, la otra red de resistencia. Si esto lo seguimos reduciendo, R1 por R1 es R1 al cuadrado.
1.5 al cuadrado.
Y el 1.5 es 1.5. ¿Ok? El denominador, R1 más 1.5 R1. Una manzana más manzana y media es 2.5 manzanas. 2.5 R1. ¿Ok? Como aquí tengo un cuadrado y aquí tengo otra R, una se cancela con esta.
Eso no
veo, ¿no? Porque R al cuadrado es R por R. Una de las R se cancela con esta y me queda una R. Entonces, 1.5 por R dividido de 2.5. ¿Ok? Entonces, 7.2 es igual a 1.5 R1 dividido por 2.5. Yo estoy buscando esto. ¿Cómo yo soluciono esto? ¿Ok?
7.2 igual a 1.5.
Para que lo veamos claro. 7.2K es igual a 1.5 R1 dividido por 2.5. ¿Verdad? Yo estoy buscando por esto aquí.
¿R1 es igual a qué?
Si yo quiero sacar esto de la ecuación, esto pasa al otro abajo, a la parte de abajo, en el denominador, ¿ok? No, dividiendo. Si está multiplicando aquí, pasa a la parte de abajo dividiendo. Entonces, 7.2 dividido por 1.5, y este que está dividiendo, pasa ya multiplicando por 2.5. ¿Ok? Por eso es 7.2 por 2.5 dividido por 1.5. Lo que tú no ves claro es la solución de la R1, ¿no? ¿Cómo se saca la R1 de la ecuación? Ahí es donde te pierde. Vamos a ver. Si yo tengo. Esto está claro, ¿no?
Está bien.
Esto está claro.
Okay, well,
Tenemos 7.2. el número ahorita.
Yeah.
¿Y bien? 1.5 entre 1.5.
Oh.
0.6.
0.6 R1.
¿Y ahora
yo quiero hacer
R1 como no?
7.2.
No, no. No quiero sacar el valor del 1 como lo hago. ¿Cómo lo haces? Esto que estamos multiplicando aquí pasa al otro lado.
Sí.
Exacto. Está multiplicando aquí, puede pasar al otro lado del dividendo. Entonces, R1 es igual a 7.2 dividido 3.6. Y eso es a 12. El IVA dice que es 1.2 por el 12. 12 kilómetros.
¿Por qué dice 1.2?
No, porque es el dinero más. Esto hace kilómetros.
No, esto es el error de 7.2.
¿Estamos claros? Lo que tiene un poco en
esto. Sí, es una regla de tres simplemente. Haces así, así. Es facilito. Acá imaginariamente cuando ves esto.
No, no, pero incluso. Si él lo divide aquí y hace la cruzada, ¿de por eso voy a resolver
esto? Sí. Cuando tú ves este caso, tú lo ves como un imaginario.
Okay.
Y aplicas la regla.
La cruz, la cruz.
Por 2.5 por el resultado de la área de 1.5 R1 por 1. ¿Entiendes? Ya lo han resumido. Esto multiplica esto, esto multiplica esto. Este resultado es 1.5 R1 y esto lo multiplica.
Ya lo ¿Cómo resuelve la gente que da un poco de trabajo?
No, practicando antes.
No, 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 pero ¿de dónde quiero llegar el punto de dónde se trabaja?
Cuando tú ves esta fracción, el
número, eso significa que está multiplicado.
Ok.
Esa es una multiplicación. Y la misma expresión aplica acá. Esto, para separar el número, esto pasa a dividir.
Sí, déjame explicarlo de otra manera. Para que lo vean más claro.
Mira. Nosotros tenemos esta ecuación, ¿no?
¿Cuál fue?
La de principio, ¿no?
Sí, sí.
Tenemos eso. ¿Vale? La divides con la calculadora. 7.2 es igual a 0.6 por R1. ¿Cómo puedo dejar el R1 solo? Si tú a una ecuación multiplicas los dos por el mismo valor, no valdría la ecuación. ¿Verdad? Por el mismo número. Si yo multiplico esto por el siguiente valor, voy a multiplicar por 0.6. Esto se elimina con esto. Y queda esto solo. También tengo que multiplicar esto por la inversa del 0.6.
Ok.
Entonces, el resultado es 7.2 dividido por 0.6. Que es solo 12. Quizás así no es más fácil.
Sí.
La multiplicación de la regla, si tú lo eliminas, y el otro lo multiplica con el valor, porque no me pongo a hacer el resultado. En la cruz y por el otro.
Sí.
¿Te das cuenta? Así va fácil. Si tú multiplicas la ecuación, los dos ángulos de la ecuación, por el mismo valor, la ecuación no varía. Porque es una igualdad. 1 es igual a 1. ¿Ok? Si yo multiplico por 5 y multiplico por 5, 5 es igual a 5, la igualdad se mantiene.
¿Ok?
Esto es lo mismo. Si yo quiero dejar solo, si quiero dejar solo el R1, en este caso, ¿por qué lo multiplico? Por la inversa. Entonces, este se me cancela con este. Él era el solo. Tengo que multiplicar el otro por el mismo valor. 1 entre 0.6. Para dividir este entre aquí me da resultado. Así no te lias con las fracciones de cruzando ni dividiendo. ¿Estamos claros? Más fácil, ¿no? Con la cruz y tal. Entonces yo quisiera hacer ese problema solo. ¿Ok? Después del break. Después del break. After the break. I am Professor Rio. We'll be back after the break. Hello, I am Professor Rios. We're back from the break, and we're going to see if my students can do this problem from scratch. Kurt is going to try to do that. The board is yours.
What's the numbers? The numbers?
The numbers. Same numbers. Hold on, let me clean this up a little bit. Right? You have them. Yeah, R1, 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 and R1. Okay? The total resistance on this table is 7.2 kilo ohms. We're trying to solve where R1 is. Show me what you got. Okay, I want to hear your thinking process.
Well, it's 7.2 first, R1 is in parallel. Okay, R1 plus. Okay.
So what happened with R1?
Yeah. Because these moves.
You have to put this in parentheses. Otherwise, it sounds like it's only this one. Okay. He's saying that R1 is in parallel with R1 that is in series, that's what it's added, with half of the value. That's what R1 is.
That's what we're
saying. R1. Up to there, you're here. You want to hear? Okay. Come on. Yes, sir.
For this, I understand what it's doing, but can we just put R1 plus R1 over 2?
Yes.
Okay.
Of course, the same thing. One half, R1 is R1 over 2. I want to hear your thinking process. If in your thinking process I hear, I have to go to the moon and come back, I know something is wrong there.
All right, so, oh, it's 7.2.
Okay.
R1 is parallel to R1, that's what it's
doing. Show me here which R1 you're talking about.
R1.
Yes.
It's parallel to.
Show me which R1. In the formula, make a reference to which R1 of this.
This R1
Yes.
This R1.
Okay.
This R1. This one.
Very well.
That's in series with R1. Parallel to R1.
Exactly. Okay. That's good.
So we know the value of the R1 is 1.
Mm-hmm.
So we do the 1 over 2 and become half. So
yes. Okay.
So 1 plus 0.5.
Out of one.
One.
Apples. No, do a big R. So that, when you go back to that, you will not know what the number means.
7.2.
Okay. So how do you do that?
So now, you take the multiply them. You do the R1 times R1 divided by R1.
Oh, excuse me.
So, when we do that now, we get 7.2 equal to. So, 1 times 1 is 1.5. R1, R1.
Where?
All right, and then we add it.
No, no, no. You're getting confused here. Okay? You're doing R1 in parallel with 1.5 R1. How do you sort that out? Do it there. Put the formula there. Put the formula there so you don't get confused. No, no, but you have to do it in the equation.
Okay.
So it is what? No, no, no. What is this value here? R1. Forget R1. R1. R1 can be any value. R1 times. R1, make it big. Make it big so you don't be shy about it. Right. No, R1. Very well. Very well. Yes? Yes, sir. Yes.
Take that.
Erase this. Erase this.
Take that.
This is right. 7.2 is equal to. So you have. So you lose track of what you're doing. What?
R1. As you cancel out here,
one cancel with the other. Okay.
Over 2.5.
Doing it right. Is
equal to what? That's what I'm doing now. So we got 7.5. 7.5. 7.2 times 2.5 equals to 18 divided by 1.5, which is not equal to R1. We divide that. R1 equals 12. So you can punch it back in there. 12.
How does R1 ended up down here?
So it was 1 plus 1.5.
You're doing this the way you're here.
Okay.
So what is that? It's in the top, right? Okay.
Now you do 18 divided by 1. 1.5, and then R1 equals 12.
How come 8 in R1 divided 1 by, what is this? You divide
18.
1.5 R1 divided by 1?
1.5.
You're messing up in the last step. Okay?
I'll do it.
This one, that equation, that's why I asked you guys, write the equations here. Okay? Look at this. This is equal to this, right?
Yeah.
So you have to write it out.
Right.
Okay. 7.2 times 2, that goes to the numerator. Okay. 1.5 goes to the denominator is equal to what?
What are you trying to figure out?
But it's equal to what? R1. So you have to write R1 is equal to this. No, 18 R1, that's where you got confused. Okay? Look, you're here. Very well up to that point. 7.2 times 1.5 R squared divided by 2.5 R1. Fine. You get the reduction. Okay? Continues to be 7.2. This one here. This one. You see, you take these two different ones. This 7.2. What do you need to do? 7.2. Is equal to what? 1.5 divided times 2.5 times R1. Because one of these eliminates this one. Now, you want to solve for R1. R1 is equal to what? That's what I'm trying to get at. So now this is equal to what?
7.2.
Very well. And that's equal to R1. That's the last. You said that and R1, no, it's equal to that. So
yeah.
don't lose track of what you're doing.
So then you multiply.
And what you were doing was right.
Yeah.
The only problem is that in this solution, you multiply that times R1. And that's that. You're solving for R1.
Yeah.
So R1 is equal to that.
Yeah.
Right? So do it. Congratulations. Let me tell you one thing, one clue. When you're solving this out, be organized. You put this R1 here. And when you turn around, and you multiply this by this? No, like be organized. Like this, put that equal sign here. And continue. If you put the R1 like in the middle of this, it gets confusing. Okay? Excellent. Next, please. Thank you. Next. Come on. Who sent away to you? You?
No, no, no.
No. Think out loud.
Okay.
How can I get R1 there? Okay.
Where can I get R1 there?
All right. 7.2 is equal to what?
7.2 is equal to. Let's pretend that this works. I'm just going to copy what it was. 7.2 kilo
Okay. Kilohertz is equal to what?
It's equal to, how is the formula again?
No, it's not formula, you have to look at that. Look at this, look.
This one is
parallel to, it's parallel, the way?
This one is parallel to. Okay, it's parallel with this one. And
it's parallel with which one?
It's parallel with this one.
No, it cannot be parallel with that one. The condition for parallelism is what?
Okay, those two are parallel.
But before you get that, tell me the relationship between this and R1.
This one is in parallel with this one.
It's impossible. R1 is in series with R1.
This one is parallel with this one.
What is the condition for elements to be in parallel?
The both beginning have to be connected.
Yes. Is the end of the R1 in the top connected to the R1 in the bottom?
So they're not in parallel.
Okay, this term that you were not paying attention. Okay? Let me read this and start. Okay. You were not paying attention. He was paying attention and he got it. You were not paying attention, you didn't get it.
We have a resistor. We have RT. Okay.
How was it?
I have like this, it's two parallel, and I have a resistor like this, okay? R1, 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 and R1. And this is our total, which is 7.2 kilo-ohms, okay?
What we need to look at is circuit reduction.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to do the circuit reduction. I'm going to combine these two.
Yeah, but you told me to start with this first. But when I said those two are parallel, and you just said.
But you can look, it's going to say this is in parallel with.
No, I said those two are parallel. And then we're divide them by two.
But when you do that, you need to find out why you're trying to do that.
Because we're looking for
Okay. I'll let you do it then. Go ahead.
No, you don't have to.
No, go ahead. Let's see what. How far you get? You should get to end like him. RT, which is 7.2,
yeah.
Is equal to what?
7.2 is equal to R1 is parallel.
Okay. With what?
To R1 with. Where is it? Yeah, which is in series with this.
Okay.
R1 and divided. No, not this one.
You're trying to live by memory. You have to look at the circle.
Okay.
You're trying to live by memory. You have to look at the circle to then
write it.
Okay.
Then we went to.
It goes to R1 in parallel.
In parallel with R1.
With what R1 is in parallel? Let's start with that.
Yes, okay.
With what the R1 on the left is in parallel?
It's
in parallel with whatever is connected to this. It's in parallel with this network. From here to here.
But you're saying
what is it parallel with this? It's not in parallel. It's parallel with the whole thing from here to here.
whatever is connected to the beginning, and then it's separated with the resultant of that. So you need to do the resultant of that. R1, okay, is in parallel with what? R1, is R1 is this one, plus, these two that are in parallel, so it will add R over 2. No, R1 plus R1 over 2. R1 and R1 that are in parallel, what is the result of the distance? It doesn't say. R1 over 2. That's it. So, I want to put here, not there, but this is in series. Here you add to this.
What I'm trying to say is, those two are one.
Exactly. So, that's the reason
why I want to have two. No. How do you do reciprocal in parallel?
That are the same.
When you have two registers, R1 over R1 plus.
That's why they are different. You can do it.
But when you have the same, it's R1 over R1. So that's only for one.
What are you for one?
If we're gonna put this and this and half, why do we need to have only one? One for it.
What is the result of the sequence of this? It will be 5K. Because it's 1 over 2 over 2 is 10. 5. So why do you need to put
that? That's right.
Okay? Don't get confused. Go on. So this is R1 in parallel with this in series with these two. That's what it means. R1 in series with these two in parallel. These two in parallel is R1 over 2. That holds right. Okay?
It's because I was trying to put it.
But when you try to do it twice, then why? What rule are you using to put it twice?
If you have one apple plus half an apple,
how many apples do you have?
1.5. So I need
1.5 is not apples, are one. So you put 1.5 are one. Are one. Is it clear? Okay. Five big numbers given. So 7.2 is equal to 1 in parallel. With R1,
if you call it 1.5, that means you think R1 is a number, no?
No. Okay. I'm just calling this a name. Okay. This is an apple and another apple. If I have an apple, one apple, and half an apple, I have an apple and a half. The same half, one and a half, whatever R1 is. Okay. So, how do you use this? When you have resistors in parallel, do the calculation. How do you do it?
now put R1 multiplied by R1 over R1 cross R1,
which is one of the values of the resistance. R1,
mm-hmm.
which is this in parallel with what is the other value of the resistance? 1.5 R1.
Yeah.
So what if this is this, what is this to be doing? 1.5 R1, not R1 by itself.
Yeah. So can I put R1 here?
Well, no, you're doing this, right?
Yeah. So when I do this, I'll do R1 multiplied by 1.5 R1.
Exactly.
That's
better. R1. R1 is 1.5 R1.
Plus
1.5
R1 again.
Exactly. So this is the whole value of the resistance. Okay? So if you continue solving this, what do you get?
R1
Okay. So now you have one unknown and an equation. How do you solve for R1?
We're just gonna R1 equal to 7. No, we have to do the division, but we have to do.
Basically we solve for this.
Yeah. Can I just add them up and put them?
Okay, what happened to the square here? So what's my square somewhere? What happened?
When I have the R2 here, it was more than just put this in place. The square here was the square. Sorry. One here. And then what was the square?
Okay. Now, how do you afford reduce that? Remember, 1.5 times R squared divided by 2.5 R is R1 is equal to 7.2K. How can we afford to reduce this? This is the same as 1.5, you eliminate 1, okay? 1.5, this is the same as R1 times R1 divided by 2.5 R1. What eliminate with this? So you are left with 1.5 R1 divided by 2.5. If you make it smaller and smaller and smaller, I'm going to bring you to Mijas, that's a small town in Spain, where in the side of a business car, they have a Padre Nuestro written on the side of the page. If you continue with your interactions, I'm going to bring you over there so you can order your skill. Okay. Now, 7.2 is equal to 1.5 times R1 divided by 2.5. How do we solve for R1?
No, it cannot be R1 by itself.
You have to solve for R1. No, I want to hear the thinking process. What do you have in doubt?
Yeah, I can ask for R1 by itself. I have to just for one. R1.
You want to have R1 by itself. How can you have R1 by itself?
from this year. 7.2 divided. No?
No, tell me what rule are you using?
I'm working on something.
Okay.
Let me have a
question. The question is that you might better be the right thing, but the question is
look. 7.2. 7.2 is equal to 1.5 divided by 2.5 out of 1. Okay? I want to solve for R1. How can I solve for R1? I want to R1 to what side?
That's going to put R1 here. R1 equal to, you're going to put 7 of it on the other. No.
What rule are you going to use to do that?
My rule. But we have to do this first.
You can do it or not. Depends. In fractions, if I want to leave to pass this to the other side, what is divided goes to multiplying.
Yeah.
And what is multiplying goes divided.
Okay, sir. No. 1.5.
You can also do that first.
Okay. Okay. I think I'll do this first. It would be easier.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
1.5 into 0.6? Is it
2.5? Yeah.
No, sir. I'm in the middle of the class right now. I didn't do attendance. I didn't do attendance yet.
Huh?
I did it. Of course I did it.
No, I'm trying to do this first. Mm-hmm. R1. Just, you know, if I'm going to get this.
So, you realize this is to be? Is what? 0.6?
Is that 0.6?
Yes.
0.6
R1.
And then R1 would be equal to 7.2 multiplied by
0.6. Why?
Because every side is good.
You're going to leave this by itself.
Yeah.
If it is multiplying here, how can it be multiplying in the other side too? Let me show you a trick. Okay? If you have RDs, R1, and you want to eliminate this, when you multiply both sides of the equation by the same number, it's unchanged. Okay? So what I have to do is to multiply this by 1 over 0.6 and the other side by 1 over 0.6. This 0.6 eliminates with this one. So R1 is 7.2 divided by 0.6. When I have an equation, in order to keep the quality of the equation, I can multiply both sides by whatever number. So I'm trying to find one number, I multiply this by to eliminate the 0.6. 1 over 0.6. 0.6 into point divided by 0.6 is 1.
Mm-hmm.
It gets eliminated. Since I multiply the other side by 1 over 0.6, it's 7.2 over 0.6. You see that part? So you don't have to do with the fractions? Okay. Another way of saying it is that in this case, you want to do it directly. What is multiplying goes to the other side dividing. And what is dividing goes to the other side multiplying. Okay? Or, if it's that far, this is the initial way to do it. You do the fraction, the calculator.
So that would not give me 12? No.
R1 is equal to 7.2 divided by 0.6. Why do you multiply this like this?
I was just asking you.
No. Look, this is the quality. Okay? We divided this by 0.6, so this cancel with this is eliminated. We are left with R1 in one side.
Mm-hmm.
In the other side, we have 7.2 that is multiplying by 1 over 0.6 because this is what we multiply on this side to keep it the same. So 7.2 divided by 0.6 is equal to 12. The fraction is where you, right?
Yeah.
But that's the easy way to solve it, okay?
All right.
Right? Thank you. Okay. Next question. Listen. Who's next? I want you to do it, Johnny, while I do the attendance, okay? You did it? Lisa? Can I do it? Greg? Two? Okay. From the previous. Yeah.
Okay.
You can use those. We live at 1:30, supposed to, but you know. Yeah. We're interrupting this guy for a moment. The other professor, you walked in to tell me that I need to do the attendance. So we're going on a break, a forced break, to do the attendance. Hello, this is Professor Rios. We're back for the break, and we're going to continue with a review of the end of the. Now,
what is the formula for clinical symptoms in parallel?
R1, R2, R3. RT is equal to what? 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. Those are multiple choices. That in one of the choices you will see something like this. In other you see the addition, something to confuse you. But if you know what it is, you know what it is. Obvious, right? Wow. What is the next one? And this three is what is RP? Things in the sense we have a multiple choice. Of whatever value,
You have to work it out.
To see what is the RT.
Okay.
And actually, we throw the battery here to do some analysis, all right? With the battery, and the question is, what is the total resistance? The total resistance is these 2 points. So you will have to calculate the total current, right? So what is the total resistance? Do it. No, first time how you do it. How you would do it. Or I'll tell you what. So I know
how I need to help you. Get a piece of paper and figure out.
And see what you're doing, okay? And then it's paper.
Okay.
What resistance?
After we have done this, is nothing. Does anyone have any doubts in how to start this thing? You have any doubts? No doubts. Okay.
45 ohms.
75.
Is 120 here, guys, okay?
Sorry, the guy. 80, 120, 45, 75, 240, 240, 240. All right? I'm sorry?
Is that output
or output? 45 ohms, but they name it, but they want a value.
Output.
But you're not going to use those numbers. You're just going to use the values. If you do, if every time you do a reduction, you redraw the circuit, that is the way you can make a mistake.
R4? R4 is 4.5?
45 ohms.
45 ohms. There was something that was there. 45 ohms.
45.
I see you looking at the drawing for too long. Do you know where the beginning or the end of that problem is? You're lost? How can you be lost after you solve in the board?
long.
No, see what you did. Okay.
You added this too? You added all this?
Mm-hmm.
It's impossible. Look, it's this point and this point. Okay. So you add these two and then becomes one.
Gotcha. I got you.
You couldn't go like that because there is another final score. Connected to the battery. So, listen, you're not doing fine? No, no, him. I'm talking about him. I see you looking at the board like he's watching a movie. Like, yeah, that's the one. Yeah, I saw him doing that. Yeah. So.
Remember, go back to place. The rules that you know. Reduction, there's no circuit, and there is no way you can make a mistake. If you try to do it in one shot, it's easy to make a mistake. Okay? But the moment you combine resistor and you draw a circuit, it is straightforward. So let me see if we need to do 700 more of these problems. ¿Alguna duda? ¿Sabe por dónde empieza? Reducir. Cuando hagan una reducción, dibujo el circuito otra vez y ya le ponen el valor para que te sea más fácil. Si dejas el circuito tal como está y empiezas a calcular y no dibujas, mira para el circuito otra vez y dice, coño, ¿usé esa resistencia o no usé esa resistencia? Y te pierde. Johnny, how are you doing? My concern is that you start inventing rules. Because you know the theory now. But the moment you get into the mode of inventing rules, forget it. There is no way you can match the right answer. It's not. You know how to add your bank account? It's the same thing. Ohms and dollars are the same. You add them and subtract them, and you divide. Think the resistors are dollars. You go, wait a minute, I cannot make a mistake with this one. Let's see.
A ver. ¿Dónde estamos? ¿Eh? Eres un caballo.
explícale a... Para que él vea exactamente lo que hiciste. ¿Ok? Explícatelo paso por paso, por favor.
Gracias por hablar bajito para que no se me desconcentre aquí el pueblo.
Yes, sir.
Yes, 140 ohm resistor. The three of them are the same. Thank you.
Number five.
Be careful,
not like that. So in parallel, the voltage is what? So which of those corresponds to the same? A bright voltage is the same as all of this. Congratulations, man. What is the answer? What is the answer? Apply voltage. Apply voltage. En un circuito paralelo, el voltaje en cada uno de los de las ramas es la resistencia total multiplicado por la corriente, el voltaje menos el voltaje menos el voltaje, la resistencia multiplicado por la corriente total o es igual al voltaje aplicado. Al voltaje aplicado, porque todos son igual. Claro, ¿no? Okay. Number six. Okay. Oh. And that's So that's clear in your mind, right? Ruben. Samuel? Eric? Curtis? Number six. I wonder. Two 400 ohms in parallel, and the voltage is 100 ohms. Okay. And what is the resistance? Okay. No, it's not 400, it's 40 ohms, I'm sorry, I said 400. 40 ohms. Congratulations. David. David y compañía. La resistencia de la figura 2. La corriente 15 or 20. The same. La corriente en la figura 2 es ¿cuánto? Son dos resistencias de 40 ohmios en paralelo. Y el voltaje son 100 voltios. No, son 4 ohmios. Son 40 ohmios. Lo que pasa es que el ohmio ese de lejos parece un cero. Es fácil, ¿no? Comparado con lo que estábamos haciendo. Esto, durmiendo, se puede hacer. ¿Está claro? ¿Cuánto es? ¿20 ohmios? ¿Y la corriente? ¿Cómo calcula la corriente? Está clarísimo, ¿no? ¿Estamos de acuerdo? You finish? What do you get? What? Right on. Congratulations. Right on. Where did you do 5 and 6? Crystal, try to do 5 and 6. Okay. What is 7 right now? A resistor of 32 ohms is in parallel with a resistor of 36, and a 50 ohm resistor is in series with the pair. When 350 volts is applied to the combination, the current through the 54 ohm resistor is what? The first thing you need to do is to draw the circuit. You draw it, you go back and read it again, you see if the reading corresponds to what you drew. If the drawing has nothing to do with that, correct it. Okay? I don't know how to draw, but. No, you can. Look, you're not gonna draw something at scale or anything like that. Resistor and connection. Easy. Okay? Curtis, a resistor of 32 ohms is in parallel with a resistor of 36 ohms. And a 54 resistor is in series with the pair. When a 354 resistor volt is applied to the combination, 350. First thing you do is to draw the circuit. Okay, ready? Draw it, go back to the reading. If it matches, then you start working on it. Lo primero es dibujar el circuito. Que si serio, lo dibuja. Lo dibujaste, léelo otra vez. ¿Es lo mismo? Sí, se empieza a trabajar. What is the first step? Draw the circuit. If you don't draw, it's going to be pretty hard to calculate, to do it.
No, no, no. Listen to me. Before you start thinking about calculating anything, draw the circle so you know what you're doing. If you don't draw it, it's like a shot in the dark. Okay? How do you draw a circle? What? Draw a resistor in parallel with another resistor, and that is a 54 resistor in series with a pair. Get a pen and pencil and try to do that. I know you guys can do it, okay? ¿Eh? Dos están en paralelo y otro está en serie con la combinación. La 6. A la izquierda, sí, ya lo hicimos. Sí, sí, es por eso. 350 voltios. 350 voltios. Treinta y dos ohmios en paralelo con 36 ohmios. Y ahí la resistencia de 54 ohmios está en serie con ese par. Bueno, escríbelo. Claro. Sí.
Exacto.
Exacto.
La respuesta que te da es 4.93.
¿Qué número
es?
4.93. Eres un caballo. No, 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 está bien, perfecto. Perfecto. Enhorabuena. De verdad. Ya lo cogiste, ¿no? Dale. Cuídate. Pero tú sabes por qué hay que dibujarlo.
Porque en ese caso es... La resistencia
que está en serie, es la total.
Pero te podría haber preguntado la resistencia por uno de la rama.
No, ya lo sé. ¿Te quieres, señor? ¿Está claro con esto, no? Easy, ¿no? You just have kind of confused with the series and parallels, you know? Yeah! See you guys tomorrow.